Hello, welcome to our Idrac training series. This video will walk you through the features available in the Idrac web interface. Upon logging into the Idrac, you are presented with the overview of the system on the dashboard. We can see the general health of the system here, as well as the power state and operating system installed if the ISM is installed on the host operating system. Under the System tab on the overview, it gives us a status of every health sensor available on the Idrac. If we look at the Inventory tab, we're able to review the hardware inventory and components, as well as any firmware version installed on the server. Under the Storage tab, we can view every item in the storage chain, including the controllers, physical disks, and virtual disks. Under the Configuration tab, allows us to configure our virtual console settings, allows us to mount or disable virtual media, can show us licenses that are installed on the Idrac, and their current status. We can also change system settings, such as the alert configuration, or some hardware settings like cooling. Under the Storage Configuration tab here, we're able to configure storage directly, as well as reset the configuration, perform actions on physical disks, or on virtual disks. Under the BIOS settings page, we're able to review the system information, as well as make changes that can be made via the BIOS. These settings do require a reboot to be applied properly, as they are applied through the lifecycle controller. Under miscellaneous settings, we are also able to perform a virtual flea drain of the server by selecting the full power cycle feature and applying the setting. Server configuration profiles allow us to import or export all current settings of the Idrac and BIOS and allow them to be imported onto another like-modeled server. On the Maintenance tab, we can see the lifecycle log showing all events on the server since the server was initially shipped. You can export this information to a file, and it will contain additional, more verbose details related to the configuration of the server. Here we can see the job queue, where all current running jobs, failed jobs, or completed jobs are listed. This job queue can be cleared, and it is important to note when running the RackAtom job queue delete with the JID clear all force feature, it will also reboot the network stack of the Idrac. The System Update tab allows us to provide a local file or a catalog, such as downloads.dell.com, for updating components or features on the Idrac. We are also able to perform a rollback to previous firmware that is stored in the Idrac if it is available. Important to know that on the Diagnostics tab here, you can perform basic functions such as ping and verify connectivity out past a gateway or connectivity to another device on the network if you're having any issues. We can see here that a ping to Google's DNS server is transmitted and received across the gateway. The Supportassist tab allows us to register the server so that dial home events can be generated and automatic case creation can occur, as well as creating a collection to collect items of interest for support. You can save this collection locally, or you can save it to a network location. Once you click collect, it will start the collection process, return to this page to download the collection once it is complete. The Idrac Settings tab provides us an overview of the Idrac settings. Here we can see the network settings currently using the dedicated NIC, as well as IPv4 settings, the status of the Idrac service module, and we can go as a quick link to these items to configure them. The connectivity tab on Idrac settings allows us to configure settings such as the network settings for the Idrac, which port, common settings such as DNS, IPv4 settings. It also allows us to configure the IPMI settings and the OS to Idrac pass-through settings. On the Services tab, we can configure the remote protocols and web server information for the Idrac. Here we can enable or disable SSH. We can configure a remote rack atom. You can also change your SSL certificate and generate a new custom certificate signing request to have signed by your certificate authority. On the Users tab, we can see a list of all local users on the Idrac, as well as directory services to add LDAP or Microsoft Active Directory authentication based on group membership. Under the Settings tab here, we can configure the time zone settings and network time provider settings for our Idrac if we want to use network time in our environment. This also includes the Idrac service module setup for configuring and installing the Idrac service module. Here we can see that it is installed and that the available version on the Idrac itself is 3.5. This can be updated through a firmware update. Here we can also see the status of the module on the operating system, as well as configure settings for it. If there is anything that you're not sure where to find in the Idrac GUI, you can go to the Help feature here in the top right corner. It will provide you a search box that will search the online manual. Thank you for taking the time to watch our introduction to the Idrac GUI features video.